Good evening, everyone. Thank you all so much for being here this evening to join us in our first concert of the season. I am very, very excited to see what they can do and for you to be able to see all of the hard work and dedication that all of them have put into this performance. I'm going to tell you a little bit about it. So our concert is entitled Dear Sincerely, A Musical Journey Through Some of History's Most Heartfelt Letters. We have 7 letters from history, from the 1800s all the way up through today, to read to you tonight, and then 7 songs to go along with each one. The way that the program is designed is that one song is gonna flow directly from one end to the other. So I would ask that you please hold your applause until after the 3 eighth grader songs, and then again until after the 4 high schooler songs. So 2 rounds of applause in total, once after they're done, and then once after they're done. And then in your program, which were on the stands as you came in, there's also some barcodes. So if you scan those, you can have a chance to actually read the letters right along with that we're reading to in the author's handwriting too. So thank you again for being here tonight, and please enjoy.
On November 5th, 2006, Kurt Vonnegut penned this letter to the students of Xavier High School in New York City after receiving letters from them as a part of an English assignment. Dear Xavier High School and Miss Lockwood, what I have to say to you, moreover, will not take long to wit. Practice any art, music, singing, dancing, acting, drawing, painting, sculpting, poetry, fictions, essays, reportage. No matter how well or badly, not to get money and fame, but to experience becoming, to find out what's inside you, to make your soul grow. Seriously, I mean right now, do art and do it for the rest of your lives. Draw a funny or nice picture of Miss Lockwood and give it to her. Dance home after school and sing in the shower on and on. Make a face in your mashed potatoes. Pretend you're Count Dracula. Write a 6-line poem about anything but rhymed. Make it as good as you possibly can. Tear it up into teeny weeny pieces and discard them into widely separated trash receptacles. You will find that you have already been gloriously rewarded for your poem. You have experienced becoming, learned a lot more about what's inside you, and you made your soul grow. God bless you all. Kurt Vonnegut.
Thank you. In the summer of 1982, 10-year-old Samantha Smith of Houlton, Maine, wrote this letter to Soviet Union leader Yuri Andropov to convince him to seek peace with the United States. Dear Mr. Andropov, my name is Samantha Smith. I am 10 years old. Congratulations on your new job. I have been worrying about Russia and the United States getting into a nuclear war. Are you going to vote to have a war or not? If you aren't, please tell me how you are going to help to not have a war. This question you do not have to answer, but I would like it if you would. Why do you want to conquer the world, or at least our country? God made the world for us to share and take care of, not to fight over or have one group of people own it all. Please, let's do what he wanted and have everybody be happy too. Samantha Smith.
Not to appear. You should dance for life, and it's not about being a dancer, but rather about the dance. Those who've never found their passion, for me it is. For example, the pleasure of walking into a studio with wooden bars and mirrors, and those who stop because they don't get the results they envisioned. They haven't entered the depths of life. It's the law of love. You love because you feel the need to do it, not to get something out of it to be reciprocated. If you feel the lather, you are destined to a life of unhappiness. I am dying, but I thank God for giving me a body which I could dance so that I didn't waste a moment of this wonderful gift of life.